Hi friends, welcome back to React.js Zero to Hero series. This series is for beginners who wants to learn React.js from scratch. In the last video, I have explained about how we can maintain states in functional component using useState hook. And I'm going to explain about the other hooks in the upcoming videos. But before that, I want to explain few more useful concepts. So in this video, I'm going to explain about how we can add images and styles in React component. Let's start. I have created a new React application in which I have created a new component and configured that in the app component. In the new component, I'm just having an image element. If the image needs to be shown in this component is hosted somewhere, we can directly use the URL in the source props of the image element. And so we can see the image. Instead of direct URL, we can also use the data URL. Like this. Now we can see this image as well. Sometimes we may need to use some local images. Inside the source folder, I have created an images folder. Inside that, I have kept an image. I want to display this image. To display the local image, first I need to import that image in my component. I can give any name here, and I need to specify the correct path, otherwise it will throw error. Also, please note that while importing, we need to give the file extension as well. But while importing the JavaScript component, we do not specify extension. Now I can use this image wherever needed. Like this. And so we can see this image is also displaying. Next, let's see how we can apply styles. For that, I have created another component. So in app component, let me command this one and configure this one. Also, in one of our previous applications, we have created a student component. Let me copy that and use it here. And so we can see this. So we are going to apply some styles in student component. In our previous applications, we have applied some inline styles. That is one way of adding styles to React component. Let me apply an inline style to this H1 tag. Let me change the color to red. Okay, another way is to use class. In React, it is going to be class name. You would have noticed this also in few of my previous applications. Let me add a class name to this div. And I can create a CSS file. And I can import this CSS file in this component. In this CSS file, I can add this class. To this class, first let me give a border. And so we can see this. I'm going to apply a few more styles. This is how we can attach a CSS file to a component and apply some styles. Okay, let me quickly create another CSS file. And let me import that in this component. And let me apply a style to that. And so we can see this. There is a drawback in this approach. We have used the student class in this student.css file only, and this file is imported only in student component. But the problem here is, in React, even though this student.css is imported only in the student component, the CSS is scoped to the entire application. That means, in another component, if I have a div with class as student, that will also get the same style. Let me show you. Let me create a div and add class name as student. So we have to be careful. Otherwise, we may override styles. That may lead to unexpected behavior. For example, if I add display none to this class in this CSS file, this will reflect there also. And so we will not see anything. Let me command this. To solve this, we have CSS modules. A CSS module is a CSS file in which all class names and animation names are scoped locally by default. So how can we make use of this CSS modules? First thing to do is we need to change the file name. Instead of .css, we need to have .module.css. Only then module bundler like Webpack will identify this as a CSS module. And so let me change that. And after that, while importing, we need to import it like this. This name can be anything. And here, instead of specifying the class name directly, we need to have it like this name.classname. And so we can see now the student class styles from this file are applied only to this component. The div from the other component is not having this style. If I inspect this, you will understand. We can see the class name is changed to some unique name. And this class name is not changed because we are not using CSS module there. Let me use there also. We can see for the other component classes, the unique names are different. And now if I uncomment this, we can see it is not reflecting here. So CSS modules are very useful to scope our CSS in React applications. Let me give you a task. You can try to create an application like this. Try to follow the exact design. You can use any images and content. Try this. If you need the solution code, you can take it from this GitHub repo. The link is available in the description. That's all for today. Please like this video, subscribe my channel, and support me. Thank you. Bye.